Good morning, students. Today we are going to continue with exercise 8.1. You people have done in yesterday's class. You people have done till question number 6. So let's continue after that. So I'm starting with question number 8. If you have your book, you can keep your book open with you. Exercise 8.1. So I'm reading the question, and if you keep the book, it will be easy for you to understand. The monthly expenses of a student have increased from ₹350. To ₹500. Find the ratio of, in this you have to find out three ratios. First is increase in expenses. Okay, what is the increase in expenses? To original expenses. Second is original expenses to increased expenses. And third is increased expenses to increase in expenses. Okay. So first we are going to write the values that are given, okay, and then whatever we have to find out according to that we'll continue. Now the ratios that you have to find out here, that says in original expenses or increased expenses. So we're going to use the same word. So what was the original expenses of the student? Original expenses were ₹350. And then it was increased. Yes. So it was increased and then the expenses were ₹500. Okay. So these are the two words that are there in the question. Yes. Along with it, there is one more term that is used here. That is increase in expenses. Okay. So there is a difference when we say increased. So in increase, we are going to tell the new value. But when we are saying increase in expenses, so this means I have to tell that what is the difference in the two, isn't it? Increase in. So how much is the increase? So increase in expenses is ₹500 minus ₹350. That is ₹150. So what is the increase in expense from ₹350? ₹150 is increase. In expense, so now the expenses are 300, sorry, 500. So now let's come to the first part, the first ratio that you have to find. The first ratio is increase in expenses to original expenses. So the first one is increase in expenses to original expenses. So let's write down the value. Increase in expenses is ₹150 and original is ₹. Okay, so now you can cancel things. Yes, this is by 3. 5 threes are 5, 7s are. So it is 3 upon 7 and in the form of ratio it is 3 is to 7. Yes, this is the answer of the first part. What we have done? We have written what was the original expense, then the increased expense, and then increase in expenses. So for increase in, we have find out the difference between the two. So 150 is the increase. So the first part is this. We have done the first part. Now let's take the second part. What is the second part? Now second part says original expenses. Increased expenses. So original expenses is ₹350 and increased is ₹500. Okay, it is increased, not increased in. So 500. Now cancel. This is 7s are, so 5 7s are, 5 10s are. So now it is 7 upon 10 and in the form of ratio it is 7 is to 10. Correct? Now let's take the third part. Now third part says you have to say increased expenses upon increase in expense. So we are going to first write increased expenses. We are comparing everything here, isn't it? Increase in expenses. So with the help of this question, we can actually, you can actually understand what is the concept of ratio. What we are doing, we are comparing everything, that what was his original value and now what is the change in the value. So we can compare everything here. Yes. So increased is rupees 500 and increase in is rupees 150. Now you can cancel. 5 threes are 10s are, it's 10 upon 3. So it is 10 is to 3. Yes. I hope this is clear. This is almost same as the questions that you people have done till now. Yes. Now, let me take a new type of question that says that you have to find out that which ratio is greater. So I'm taking question number 11, second part. That has two ratio. First ratio is 11 is to 21 and second ratio is 15 is to 28. And you have to check that which ratio is greater. Okay. So as we have done in fractions, when you people have studied fraction, what we used to do? When you have two fractions to compare that which fraction is greater, what we do? We cross multiply them. And whichever side is greater, we say that that fraction is greater. Similarly, in this also, we first convert them in the form of fraction. And after converting them in the form of fraction, we compare them by cross multiplication. And after cross multiplication, we come to know that which ratio is greater. So 11 upon 21 can be written as this. And this is, now as I said that we are going to use cross multiplication. By cross multiplication. It is very important that you put this sign of cross here. Okay, that's why this method is called cross multiplication here, because we are making a cross here. So with 11, you have to multiply 28 and 21 with 15. Yes. So now multiply 11. Okay, there is a very easy and interesting method with you can multiply any two digit number with 11. You know what I have done to do the calculation just now? It's very easy. What you do? You don't have to actually read the table of 11 or do something like this. You can very easily do this. I saw these two digits. It is 2 and 8. 28. So I write 8 here. Okay. And then you add these two digits. So 8 plus 2 is 10. So you write 0 here. 10. So 1 carry. So this 2 will become 3. So this is 308. Now 15 and 21. 15 and 21 will be 15 ones are and 230, 315. Now can we compare these two values? Yes, we can compare these two values. We have 315 greater than 308. Now this shows that which fraction is, which ratio is greater? This ratio. Now this implies 11 is to 21 is less than 15 is to 20. Okay, I hope this is clear. This is same what we do for fractions. When we compare two fractions, the method that we follow is same. That we convert them in fractional form, we cross multiply them. When we multiply, whichever side is greater, is greater. Whichever number is greater. And that side, that ratio is greater. Yes. Now, let's come to one more question after this. But before we come to this question, let me first tell you the difference between fraction and ratio. So if you know exactly the difference between fraction and ratio, these questions that we'll be doing will be more clear to you. Okay, so what is the difference between fraction and ratio? So let's take to one example. I'm taking 4 is to 5. So this is fraction that I have taken. 4 upon 5. And the ratio that I am taking, I'm again taking 4:5. So that you understand that what is the difference. Now, what is fraction? Fraction is a part of a whole, isn't it? So when we talk about fraction, whatever is in the denominator tells you the whole part. Yes? And whatever is in the numerator is the part that we have taken. Isn't it? So we'll say that we have taken 4 part out of 5. So here the total parts in, when we talk about fraction, here the total parts are 5. And these 5 parts, out of these 5 parts, we have taken 4. So what we will say? We will say 4 parts out of 5. Yes? Now come to ratio. Now what is ratio? In ratio, we are not taking the whole part. This second term is not actually telling me the whole part. I am actually comparing two things here. Since we are doing division, so it takes a form of fraction. We are comparing it with division, so it takes the form of fraction. But actually, this 5 is not whole here. These are the two parts of a quantity that we have taken. Yes? So when we say ratio, then out of, or we can say total parts are, total parts are 4 + 5, 9 parts. Okay, are you getting? Total parts are 9 parts when we talk about ratio. And out of that 9 parts, what we are taking? We are taking 4 parts and 5 parts for comparison. Okay, so we are taking 4 parts and 5 parts for comparison. Out of 9 parts, this is what we do in ratio, that out of these, this total quantity means 9, 4 + 5, 9 parts, I am comparing 4 part and 5 part. This is ratio. And what fraction says? Fraction says that this is the number of parts that I am doing, these are the number of parts that I am doing. So I am doing 5 parts, and out of 5 parts I am taking 4 parts. Okay, so is this difference between the fraction and ratio clear? With this, with the help of this part, this ratio part, we are going to continue with the next question or all the remaining questions. So it is very important for you to understand that when anything is written like this in the ratio, then this 5 does not represent the whole quantity. These two represents part and part, and the sum of these two represent whole quantity. Okay. Now let me take the next question. Question number 12. Now question number 12 says, divide rupees 560. So here the total amount is total, whole part. Isn't it? This is what I was talking about, whole part. So here the whole part is rupees 560. Now divide rupees 560 between Ramu and Mummy in the ratio 3:5. Okay, now first understand what they are saying. They are saying that I have to divide this amount between Ramu and Mummy in the ratio 3:2. So this means I have, what I have to do, I have to divide this 560 into, the ratio is 3:2. This means 5. So I have to divide this amount into 5 equal parts. Out of these 5 equal parts, 3 part I have to give to Ramu and 2 part I have to give to Mummy. Okay, so the concept of ratio is this, that it does not represent, this is not representing the whole. These are representing the part when we talk about ratio. So 3 part and 2 part, the total 5 part we have to do of this whole, and out of these 5 part, 3 part Ramu will take and 2 part Mummy will take. Okay, so let me solve this, that how we solve this. So given ratio is 3:2. So we will first do the sum of the ratio. Sum of the ratio, so that we get the total number of parts that we have to do. I have to do 5 parts. So Ramu's share will be Ramu share is three part out of five part. Yes, this amount is divided into five parts, out of which Ramu will take three part. So what share Ramu is taking? Ramu is taking 3/5 part. Yes, now 3/5 part of what? 3/5 part of what? Of this money. So we'll say 3/5 part of this money. Understood? This is very important that you understand this. Then take Munni's case. I will solve this later on. First you understand this, that how we write, why we write this. Now Munni's share is 2 part out of how many parts? 5 parts. So 2 part Munni will take out of 5 part of what? Of this amount. Okay, that's why we write 3/5 of this, 3/5, sorry, of this. Yes, now we'll solve this. Now we solve, this is easy now to solve. 3/5 of means multiply of rupees 560. Now cancel this. 5 ones are, then again 5 ones are and 2. So this is 3 multiplied by 112. So 3 multiplied by 112 means this is Ramu's share. Now one very interesting thing is this, that if I know the total amount, I know Ramu's share, so can we find out Munni's share without this method? Yes, you simply subtract the two value, you get Munni's share. That is also correct. Okay, but if you want to do it with the same method, you can do it with the same method also, no problem. So 2/5 of rupees 560, again cancel it, 112, and that will give me rupees 224. Now whenever you do these type of questions, then you can check also whether you have done it correct or not. So you add the two value, it should be 506. I hope this is clear to everyone what we have done here. Yes, now let me take one more question. Very quickly, I'm going to take one more question. That the ratio of Ankur's money to Roma's money is 9:11. This is question number 14. The ratio is 9:11. You have Ankur's money and Roma's money. Ankur money and Roma money. 9:11. So total the money is divided into 20 parts, out of which Ankur will take 9 part and Roma will take 11 part. If Ankur has rupees 540, they have given Ankur's money. So the money Ankur's have, we have that. Now how much? Now what they are asking? How much money does Roma have? So now they are asking that Ankur's money is 20 part, this 9 part is actually 540. Okay, and you have to tell what is this 11 part is. You have to tell Roma's money. So how are we getting this ratio? How are we getting this ratio? We are getting this ratio when we are writing Ankur's money. And we are writing Roma's money. And when we write and cancel, we divide, we get 9/11. This is the ratio that is given here. Yes. Now what you have to do, you have to find out Roma's money. And Ankur's money is given. So let's write Ankur's money. 540 upon Roma's money. And it is equal to 9:11. Yes. Now can we cross multiply and solve this? Yes, you can cross multiply and solve this. So let's cross multiply and solve this. So this will be, cross multiply means rupees 540 multiplied by 11. Rupees 540 multiplied by 11. Yes, and this 9 will come here. Okay, this 9 will come here and this will come here. This is what cross multiply means when we do so. Now this is Roma's name. Now cancel. 9 ones are and 9 6 are. So you have 60 multiplied by 11. And that is Roma's money, and 60 multiplied by 11 is 660. So Roma's money is 660. Yes, now that is it for today. The number of questions and whatever assignment is there, that will be mentioned in the instruction. You can follow that. Thank you so much.